Good morning and welcome to worship on this Sunday. We are so thankful that you are worshiping with us here online and for those who are with us in person in the sanctuary. This Sunday, we have an exciting day. After worship, we are inviting anyone that would like to join us to come to Seaver's Corn Maze and Fall Festival. We will be there from 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. We are not providing transportation, so we hope that you meet us there for just a fun day of being out in God's creation, going through the corn maze and the corn pit, and enjoying some time together. So if you'd like to join us again, that's 1 p.m. to 3 p.m. today. This month, we are collecting wipes, baby wipes, and sanitizing wipes that will be donated to Neighbors, Inc., and then again given to neighbors here in our community in need. We have collected, over this month, 103 wipes. So thank you guys so much for donating all of those. That will, again, go to Neighbors, Inc., and then next month, we'll announce the new collection of what we're gathering for neighbors. If you are a worshiper here online or even on local television, and you'd like to take communion with us, here at church, we have these self-serve communion cups. On the top, there's a wafer, and inside there is juice. We have a bowl of these right in the narthex by the coat closet, and you are welcome anytime to come and grab some of these cups. We want you to be able to engage and worship and take communion with us. If you can't make it into church and you would still like some, please give us a call, and we can coordinate getting some of these cups to you. So again, we want you to participate fully in the worship service with us. And speaking of this worship service, this Sunday is our very last Sunday of pre-recording worship. But don't worry, we will still be online. You can still find us on YouTube, on our Facebook page, on local television. We will just be live streaming starting Sunday, October 3rd. So what you will see will be just the sanctuary during our normal in-person worship service. So we will still be bringing you God's word, wonderful music, communion, announcements, the whole worship experience. It will just be live streamed instead of pre-recorded. At the end of this service, you can catch the times where we will be on local television. It's switching to channel 15 as of October 2nd. And again, it's on a rotating schedule, and we will have that on the end of this video. With that in mind, we really want to give a huge thank you to the Holy Spirit for bringing us Paul Dunlop, who has put all of this together, who has helped guide us through this year and a half of worshiping online with technology. So we thank him for his skills, his time, and his energy put into these services. We also thank him for being our assisting minister today, and we thank Linda Hansen for being our reader. Let us take a moment of silence to prepare our hearts and our minds for worship. We gather for worship this morning in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. God of all mercy and consolation, come to the help of your people, turning us from our sin to live for you alone. Give us the power of the Holy Spirit, that we may confess our sin, receive your forgiveness, and grow into the fullness of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. Let us pray. Most merciful God, we confess that we are captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for us. And for his sake, God forgives us all of our sins. As a called and ordained minister in the Church of Christ, and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all of your sins. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
Praise the Most High. Come, all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come, all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come now and worship the Lord.
Come, all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come, all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come, all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come now and worship the Lord. Come all you people, come and praise the Savior. Come all you people, come and praise the Savior. Come all you people, come and praise the Savior. Come now and worship the Lord.
Come all you people, come and praise the Spirit. Come all you people, come and praise the Spirit. Come all you people, come and praise the Spirit. Come now and worship the Lord.
Come all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come all you people, come and praise the Most High. Come now and worship, come now and worship.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Let us pray. Generous God, your Son gave his life that we might come to peace with you. Give us our share of your Spirit, and in all we do, empower us to bear the name of Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen.
The first reading today comes from James chapter 5, 13 through 20. Are any among you suffering? They should pray. Are any cheerful? They should sing songs of praise. Are any among you sick? They should call for the elders of the church and have them pray over them, anointing them with oil in the name of the Lord. The prayer of faith will save the sick, and the Lord will raise them up, and anyone who has committed sins will be forgiven. Therefore, confess your sins to one another and pray for one another so that you may be healed. The prayer of the righteous is powerful and effective. Elijah was a human being like us, and he prayed fervently that it might not rain. And for 3 years and 6 months, it did not rain on the earth. Then he prayed again, and the heaven gave rain, and the earth yielded its harvest. My brothers and sisters, if any among you wanders from the truth and is brought back by another, you should know that whoever brings back a sinner from wandering will save the sinner's soul from death and will cover a multitude of sins. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
It's time for our children's message, so I invite all of the children of God to come a little bit closer to the screen. This morning I brought one of my favorite things, stickers. Does anybody else out there love stickers? I hope some of you are with me, right? You guys might even have some stickers at home. But I remember when I was younger and I was in school, we often got a sticker when we did something well. Right? Like maybe I finished my homework assignment, so I would get a sticker on there. Right? Or I was the first one to line up and be quiet and in the right space, so I might get a sticker. Right? It's kind of silly to think about this, but this little tiny sticker is actually a way to encourage. Do you guys know what that means, to encourage? Yeah, maybe, maybe not. It's kind of a big word. It means to lift someone up, right? To help them out, to be kind with your words, right? All that stuff is encouraging, right? And this sticker encourages us because it lets us know, hey, you did a good job. Here's a sticker. So I'm going to put this one on my robe here as a reminder of that encouragement. Right? And we have all sorts of people that encourage us as we learn and grow and go to school, right? Hopefully our parents and our siblings might be encouraging. They might be kind to us and help us when we need it. Hopefully our teachers, right, encourage us as we learn and try new things. Maybe even a coach, right? As we play sports and we, again, try new and different things, they might encourage us, give us kind words and help us out. Well, did you guys know that somebody here at church is here to help you? Right? There's people here at church who what they do is encourage you. Maybe you could think of actually lots of people here at church, but who I'm thinking about is our Sunday school teachers. Who here is either in or has ever been in Sunday school? I was certainly in Sunday school growing up, right? And our Sunday school teachers, no matter who they are, they help us learn and grow, and they help us understand how much God loves us. So their whole role is to encourage us. Kind of like this sticker here. They're always with us, encouraging, lifting us up, giving us kind words so that we can learn about God's love. Well, this morning, we're going to pray, and we, you and me, we are going to be encouraging for our Sunday school teachers, right? Praying for each other's one way God says that we can lift each other up, be kind and encouraging. So this morning, I want you to stand up, get in your favorite prayer posture, right? That's another kind of big word, but you can fold your hands, bow your heads. You could raise your hands up. You could even be laying down. Whatever prayer position is comfortable, and let's you and me encourage our Sunday school teachers. So please repeat after me. Dear God, thank you for Sunday school teachers. We pray that you are with them and that you would help them as they teach and encourage us. We thank you for loving all of us. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Awesome. Thank you guys for being encouraging this morning, and we pray that this year of Sunday school is very, very fun and exciting, and that you stay encouraged. Our gospel reading for this morning comes from Mark chapter 9. John said to him, "Teacher, we saw someone casting out demons in your name, and we tried to stop him because he was not following us." But Jesus said, "Do not stop him, For no one who does a deed of power in my name will be able soon afterward to speak evil of me. Whoever is not against us is for us. For truly I tell you, whoever gives you a cup of water to drink because you bear the name of Christ will by no means lose the reward. If any of you put a stumbling block before one of these little ones who believe in me, it would be better for you if a great millstone were hung around your neck and you were thrown into the sea. If your hand causes you to stumble, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life maimed than to have two hands and go to hell, to the unquenchable fire. And if your foot causes you to stumble, cut it off. It is better for you to enter life lame than to have two feet and be thrown into hell. And if your eye causes you to stumble, tear it out. It is better for you to enter the kingdom of God with one eye than to have two eyes and be thrown into hell, where their worm never dies and fire is never quenched. For everyone will be salted with fire. Salt is good, but if salt has lost its saltiness, how can you season it? Have salt in yourselves and be at peace with one another. This is the gospel of our Lord. Let us pray. Gracious and loving God, we give you thanks for this day. We thank you for your word, for the gospel. We thank you that it is alive and it still speaks to us today. On this day, with this particularly challenging text, we ask that you open our hearts and our minds to hear you, to encounter Jesus Christ, your Son. We pray that your Holy Spirit would be with us, guiding us this day and always. In your name we pray. Amen. So I worked as a camp counselor at Flathead Lutheran Bible Camp. Now each week in the summer, we would get a new assignment. Some weeks we would have a cabin of campers. Other weeks we might be traveling to a new town to lead VBS or day camp. And some other weeks, we would be in charge of an off-site adventure. One week we might be sailing, another whitewater rafting, or another rock climbing. Now during those particular off-site adventure weeks, the campers would come in on Sunday. We would spend that afternoon and the next day preparing for this week-long adventure. We would work with the kids to pack up all of our supplies so we would have food and first aid and tents. We would go through all the safety protocols, what we do in case of an emergency, and then we would spend some time with team-building activities. Because we were going out into the wilderness to camp for a week and do some somewhat dangerous activities, so it was important that this new group of campers, who were often complete strangers, that they got some time to work together. Some of these team-building activities, we would get the campers on one side of an 8-foot wall, and we would task them with getting every person on the other side without going around. Or we might lay out a tarp in the big field. We'd put all the campers on the tarp, and we'd task them with flipping the tarp without having anyone stepping off. Now, to make these team-building activities just a little more challenging, we would take bandanas and we would tie them on some of the campers' arms, and they couldn't use that arm. Or we might tie it on a leg, and they couldn't use that leg. Or others, we might even blindfold them so they had to rely on the other campers to help them out. Well, no matter how many groups I led through these activities, they almost always turned out the same. We would give the campers the task, and immediately a few of them would jump into action and climb the wall or flip a portion of the tarp, leaving the rest of their team behind. When they got stuck, we then had to start all over again. Then they would try another way, they would fail. They would try and fail until they finally coalesced as a team and they worked with each other to complete the task. Each time we did these activities, the campers would learn by the end that the group as a whole was more important than any individual person. In Mark chapter 9, Jesus is with a group of followers. Not a group of campers, but a group of 12 disciples. As a group, they're traveling around from city to city, and Jesus is healing people. Jesus is teaching and proclaiming God's kingdom here on earth. Jesus is performing miracles. Well, as they travel around, some of the disciples encounter a person who's casting out demons in the name of Jesus. And this particular person, he didn't belong to this group of 12 disciples. He hadn't been following Jesus from town to town. So the disciples try and stop him to do no more work in the name of Jesus. Still upset by this encounter, the disciples come to Jesus, and John tells him about what happened. They were so concerned with who belongs in this small group of disciples and who doesn't belong that they completely missed the point that someone was doing good. Someone was actually helping people and doing it in the name of God. So Jesus tells them not to stop this person. Jesus proclaims that whoever is not against us is for us. Jesus takes this opportunity to teach the disciples a valuable lesson. He doesn't lead them in a team-building activity by an 8-foot wall or on a tarp. Rather, Jesus gives them two extreme examples. The first one, Jesus says, if disciples of Jesus discourage other believers, or if disciples of Jesus cause harm to others, it's better for them to have a millstone or a boulder tied around their neck and thrown into the sea. The second extreme example that Jesus uses to teach the disciples is the image of their own body. If their hand causes them to stumble, Jesus says, cut it off. If your foot causes you to stumble, cut it off. If your eye, tear it out. Jesus says, it's better to enter heaven maimed than to be thrown into hell. These two images are extremely disturbing. But Jesus is trying to shock his disciples. He's trying to drive home the point that the whole is more important than any individual person or individual group. Jesus Christ came to share God's kingdom with the whole world, not just 12 individual disciples. Followers of Jesus Christ should encourage others who are doing good work, no matter who they are. Followers of Jesus Christ should sacrifice some of their own individual wants and behaviors so that others can be included. Inclusion and self-sacrifice. This is exactly what Jesus was sent to do. Jesus was sent into the world to break down barriers, to extend God's promise of love and inclusion to every single person, no matter who they were. Jesus was actually sent into your life so that you could be included in God's family, so that you would be loved by God no matter what. In fact, Jesus sacrificed his own life on the cross for the forgiveness of all people, no exceptions, so that in the life, death, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven. You are given new life, and you are part of the body of Christ. The body of Christ is inclusive. The body of Christ is self-sacrificing because the world as a whole is more important than any individual person or individual group. Jesus ends this lesson that he's teaching the disciples. He ends the lesson for you and me today by saying, "Have salt in yourselves, be at peace with one another." That image of salt we see again and again throughout the Gospels. And in a time without refrigeration, salt was an invaluable resource. Salt was used to preserve food, and without it, it's hard to sustain life. So when Jesus says, "Have salt in yourselves," he's saying that as a disciple and as a follower of Christ, your call, your responsibility is to be salt, is to preserve and sustain life. Life of all creation, this world that God created, all of the resources that we have, we are called to sustain and preserve. Life of all people, we're called to be inclusive without exception. We are called to encourage all who do good works. We're called to encourage all who help others, regardless of if they belong to our church, our religion, or even our nation. We are called to self-sacrifice when our actions cause harm or others to stumble. We are called to work toward peace rather than to flame conflict and division. We are called to pray with and pray for one another whenever we struggle. Because creation as a whole, the needs of all people are more important than an individual person or an individual group. As a follower of Christ, your call, your responsibility is to be salt, to preserve and sustain life, just as Christ has done for you. Thanks be to God. Amen.
Through the storm, through the night.
take my hand. Precious Lord, lead me home. When the darkness appears and the night draws near and the day is past and gone, at the river I stand, guide my feet.
Let us confess our faith with the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray for the whole people of God in Christ Jesus and for all people according to their needs. All-powerful God, we give you thanks. We thank you for everything we have, our family and friends, our homes and property, our health and happiness, our skills and knowledge, everything we have and everything we know. Lord, in your mercy. Creating God, we are in awe of the natural wonders of your creation. Help us restore damaged forests, waterways, and natural habitats, and teach us to be good stewards of what you have provided. Lord, in your mercy. Teaching God, we pray for those in authority. Give them wise minds and compassionate hearts. Strengthen in them a desire to protect the earth and its inhabitants and to bring an end to racism and extremism. Lord, in your mercy. Leading God, we pray for the church and its ministry. Bless the newly baptized and encourage them in their journey of faith. Support all members of the body of Christ in their lives of prayer, service, and worship. Lord, in your mercy. Healing God, we pray for those who are struggling with COVID, cancer, dementia, or any other disease. Give them the strength, resilience, and peace necessary for the days ahead. Sustain the caregivers with energy, compassion, and patience. Lord, in your mercy. Gracious God, we pray for the worship leaders of Luther Memorial Church, Pastor Patrick, musicians, readers, assisting ministers, ushers, team members, and staff. Bless us all through their ministry and grant them the passion to continue in their service. Lord, in your mercy. Sympathetic God, we pray for peace and comfort for the family and friends of recently departed Roger Schwagmeyer. May they all feel your presence and reassurance in the days and months ahead. Lord, in your mercy. Healing God, we pray for your health and healing for Connie McAllister, Marlene Astrike, Marlis Cornelison, Doreen Berry Hill, Pat Dunlop, Irene Heilman, Pam Schwantes, Dan Zerich, Vanessa and Jeremiah Berg, Marion Rickey, Lindsay Johnson, Leon, Bernice, Justin, Ken, and Alyssa. Lord, in your mercy. Mighty God, we pray for your strength and encouragement for our homebound, Doug and Marlis, Ruth, Janie, Gloria, Luther, Claudia and Stephen, Carol, Joanne, Margot, Doris, and Bev. Lord, in your mercy. Receive these prayers, O God, and those in our hearts known only to you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Please share a sign of God's peace with one another.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of all. When darkness seems to hide His face, I rest on His unchanging grace. In every high and stormy gale, my anchor holds within the veil. Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love. Through the storm, He is Lord, Lord of all. When He shall come with trumpet sound, oh, may I then in Him be found, dressed in His righteousness alone, faultless stand before the throne.
Let us pray. God of all creation, all you have made is good, and your love endures forever. You bring forth bread from the earth and fruit from the vine. Nourish us with these gifts, that we might be for the world signs of your gracious presence in Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. At this time, I invite you to gather either your self-serve communion cups or to get some bread and some juice or wine, so that we can partake in communion together. Once you have those supplies, we will hear the words of institution, we will pray the Lord's Prayer together, and then we will eat and drink as the body of Christ. In the night in which He was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread. He gave thanks, He broke it, and He gave it to His disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, He took the cup. He gave thanks, and He gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me." Let us pray together the prayer our Lord Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. As you eat the bread, hear these words. This is the body of Christ given for you. As you drink the juice or the wine, hear these words. This is the blood of Christ shed for you. May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ strengthen and preserve you in eternal life. Amen. Let us pray. O God, we give you thanks that you have set before us this feast, the body and blood of your Son. By your Spirit, strengthen us to serve all in need and to give ourselves away as bread for the hungry. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord's face shine on you and be gracious unto you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.
To the depths of the sea, creation's revealing your majesty. From the colors of fall to the fragrance of spring, every creature unique in the song that it sings, all its
can fathom in this world.
Go in peace. Christ is with you. Thanks be to God.